sports. It's in the game.
We attacking better, stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the options and big blitz. Nobody blocking, big win. That's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in the slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk. I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that. Chewbacca that.
First opened in 2002. There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Both teams emerging from the Ford Field tunnels just a short time ago. And, of course, the loudest cheers were reserved for the hometown Lions. They're set to go as they will match up with the Carolina Panthers. 2 weeks have come and gone. It's off to week three, and we're underway on EA Sports. Returnable here for Davis. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. Mayfield now looking to throw on first down. Open man is Denzel Mims. Touchdown, Carolina! Denzel Mims, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. First play from scrimmage all the way into the end zone. It, look, the pass was good, but that run after the catch, that's what was really impressive.
And I think the big question I have is, where were the safeties? Where was the tackling? Because going into this game, they had to know that they were going to be tested. That was a part of the defense that had to stand up. And on that play, not even close.
So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. This is going to be returned from middle of the end zone.
Well, not exactly a banner return, so he doesn't give his offense a whole lot of room to work with. They've got to go a long way now to try and score some points. I do know this from experience. There will be a few comments muttered his way by the offense as they head out on the field.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Throwing left side, it's complete. The 40, 20, 10, and in for the Lions touchdown. A great effort there. 95 yards. And the Lions have tied it. If they hit the extra point, they'll have the lead. Crosby connects on the extra point, and they take the lead here at 7-6. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Returnable here for Davis. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again. There he goes, left side. The 30, 10, 5, touchdown. Denzel Mims, 78 yards. And the Panthers are going to jump back in front.
If you didn't know it, it won't surprise you to find out that this team leads the league in scoring. They've been a quick strike team all season long. There's another example. They did it again. This offensive coordinator, right now you can write his ticket towards being a head coach. He's advanced in the ways of offense.
So now the Panthers making the decision. They're going to go for two. They run with McCaffrey off the option. And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more. Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. Good starting field position for him as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. He'll drop to throw. Looking left side, and it's complete. Touchdown, Detroit! A great play there. His second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Just an unbelievable start. Less than a minute in, they're already up two touchdowns.
You talk about getting out of the gate fast. I mean, beyond fast. That's warp speed, isn't it? To jump up with two scores like that in less than a minute's time, your confidence has to be elevated.
I haven't even found the right height for my chair yet. I'm still adjusting.
You mean you found a way to sit down?
I did, yeah.
Wow, you're quick.
At least I got that accomplished.
I'm still standing watching this occur.
And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up two more. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was real easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here. Second and six. No, scratch that. Second and seven. Field to throw it. Taking a shot here for Marshall, and that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
He certainly had a good game throwing the ball so far, but I think he was trying to take that from good to great with that throw, trying to get one downfield.
They head to the line facing a third and seven following the incompletion on second down. To throw, Mayfield. That is caught by Mims. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
With the kind of game he's had so far, you had to know that on third down that they would be looking his way, and they did, for big yardage and a first down. I think the defense fell asleep at the switch on that one. I would have doubled him, tripled him, anything to keep the ball out of his hands.
And he's going to get it across the midfield stripe into Lion territory. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and four. Now, this defense for the Lions, very strong last week as they helped their squad improve to 2-0 on the young season.
Yeah, and what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down, and they're playing with extreme confidence.
Dancing to his left. And he'll just get rid of it.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Mayfield. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Good. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. McCaffrey on the counter, and he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out if they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
Mayfield on third and 2. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Corey Willis. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Well, he's certainly not been afraid to take some chances downfield. Now look, it's paid off for him a couple of times. That time, not so fortunate.
And that's where I want to start, what you said. It's paid off a couple of times. So his aggressiveness has been good for his offense for the most part. So he throws an interception there. No one likes that. But I would not rein him back in. The return on investment thus far has been pretty good. 2 touchdowns to 1 interception.
And he's got Rome. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. 31 yards there and a first down. Boy, the offensive line there, that was a thing of beauty to watch them block.
I love how you give a little appreciation for those big guys up front, and well-deserved. But how about the execution behind them? You can see the hours of practice that have gone into it. Great pocket by the running back. Quarterback puts it right in the perfect spot. Great mesh point by them. The timing on point. The run even better.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. They'll run right here with Swift. He'll get about 4 as he's past the 35 to the 38-yard line.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. They run out of the gun with Swift. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. A loss of 1 yard, and it brings up 4th. So on 4th down, here's Sam Cook to punt it away.
You rarely call your punter a weapon, but he certainly was there. How about that? Pinning him down at the 1-yard line and helping out the defense in a big way. I'm telling you what, if I'm a defensive coordinator, I might be thinking safety right now.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said as they went back out there was, don't do that again. What do you think?
What do you think?
Yeah, I think that. I think that not only did he say that, but he also told him, let's put it in the end zone that it's supposed to be in, all right? The end zone we're trying to score. I know we're being a little bit facetious here, but the bottom line is take care of the football and everything else should flow from there.
Quick lesson, never ask the play-by-play guy a question.
Hey, you're my partner. I know you're right there with me.
And they'll hit him for a loss as he's back to his 2-yard line. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8. That last play, backwards 1 yard. We are in for a good one as we're through 1 on EA Sports. The Panthers on 3rd down. They've been okay play, 2 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Out of his end zone, Mayfield. And he fires one, but incomplete.
That could be the stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here in the first half. After that possession, now they know that they can compete with this offense.
So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on 4th and 8. Now they're indeed going. It's Mayfield. And Marshall's got it. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to him. 4th down, no problem. 19 yards that time, but now it's 1st and 10. Mayfield knocks this forward. It's a jet sweep.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on him before he could get much out of it.
Ball at the 23, 2nd and 8. Mayfield. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively, and now it brings up 3rd down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Again, it's Mayfield. Quickly into the hands of Mims. And he is going to have a Panthers 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. 2nd down.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly. And that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. Here we go.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside, and he just showed it right there. Pretty good arm, too.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a 1st down in the red zone. Down to the 6-yard line on a pickup of 6 as he gets halfway to the goal line.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a 1st down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Another run, this time McCaffrey. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. And give him about 4 on the play, but he's marked short, so it'll be 3rd and about the length of the football. And the pressure gets to McCaffrey as they stop him short of the line to gain. That'll make it 4th down after a loss of 1.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
So the snap will come from the three, but remember, they don't need the touchdown. They can get the first down if they get a yard and the ball gets to the two. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down, and that will force a turnover on downs. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up five or six first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. To throw. He's got it. This is Ware. And he's going to get this deep on a Carolina side of the field. Excellent execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever? Red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
So the field flips here as they'll go to work at the 20 now on first and 10. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And in for the Lions touchdown. A great effort there. On his way to a monster game, three first half touchdowns. And the Lions are able to grow their lead.
And remember, partner, that's a rookie quarterback back there. Apparently, he's getting the hang of this NFL thing pretty quickly.
Yeah, three touchdown passes. You're right. He looks comfortable. What are they doing? Anything in particular?
Well, they keep talking about making sure they're giving him plays that fit his talents and also maybe shrinking the playbook a little bit. They did tell us that. Bottom line, he's really good.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And with them trailing, there is still enough time to try to string a few plays together, maybe get into field goal range. And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Mayfield now. He'll get this out wide here to McCaffrey. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. Mayfield off the play fake. Pressure comes and down goes Baker Mayfield. The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Here's the Panthers punter now. Back deep, Jarvis Landry. Yards on the punt there, and the Lions will take over. Yards. Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And with great starting field position and a couple of timeouts at their disposal, they'll certainly have the green light here. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. From the gun, here's Swift. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game. Now back to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Incomplete. And we're down to 8 seconds now.
They went with the dive look that time on defense. Just flooded the field with defensive backs. Blanketed everyone. Took away all the passing angles. Thus, the incompletion.
Here's Sam Cook now. As he'll punt it away for the second time. Yards on the punt, give him just 1 yard on the return, and there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive, and they'll have time for one play. It's 2 seconds on the clock. A run on first down, but it's not going to get him much, maybe a yard, and that's all. So we've reached halftime here in Detroit with the Lions out on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. The Lions in the lead, and they're going to get the football first as well as the second half is underway. And the half will begin with a touchback. Third quarter starts with a run from Swift. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 15 yards is the pick up there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here, because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Now a second down and 6. On the handoff, this is Swift. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6. Back to throw here. And that's out to the flat for Swift. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. So from Panther territory now, it's 1st and 10 down at the 33. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Looking deep downfield. He's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. A great play there. 3 yards. And the Lions are able to extend their lead. They'll try and run it up the middle. And he is going to lose yardage here. And he is not going to get in there. He stops short of the goal line, and the lead is going to stay right where it is. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Throwing, Mayfield. And this one's incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
So second and 10 now here in the third quarter from Detroit. Now Mayfield. Flushed out right. And that'll be incomplete.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Play fake, Mayfield. Able to connect with Mims. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that
first.
Wasn't the first option.
No, not it came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
Mayfield now from the 50. And that's complete to Marshall on the crossing route. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 23 yards on the play. Play action now. Here's Mayfield. And that's to Mims, who makes a nice catch. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 6 yards on the pickup, and that'll make this a second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Call it no gain that time, as it's going to leave him with a third and about 3 to go. Hey, They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. On the ground, McCaffrey. And this time, he is in.
Yes.
Christian McCaffrey, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Panthers are able to cut into this deficit here in the final minute of the 3rd. And it's no good. It has not been his day. That's the 2nd extra point he's missed so far. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
Here's 2nd and 8. He's going to air one out. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's 3rd down.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and give the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side. And all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
On 3rd down, here comes Swift. And he will be very close to a 1st down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means 4th down. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and that's going to bring up a 4th down. And that is going to do it for this 3rd quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on 4th down. And he will have a 1st down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on 4th down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Now a give, right side, Swift. And he'll take this up over the 40 to about the 41. A gain of 3, 2nd down. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
Right back to Swift again on 2nd down. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 61 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front 7, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
An opening there on that 1st down run as he gets this forward for about 8 or 9. That looks to be 8 officially, so 2nd and 2. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 2 yards, good enough for a 1st. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Give the tackle to Hassan Reddick. Clock continuing to run. They'll probably wind this all the way before snapping it on second down. Here's a handoff to Swift. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. Now the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right, but the problem for them is still within a possession, so they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
The Lions on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 4. He'll buy some time right. And tight coverage there. It's knocked away, incomplete.
They really had a good drive going there, but a nice recovery by the defense these past few downs. Able to knock that one away on third down and bring up what I think for the offense, an unexpected 4th down here.
And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on 4th down. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Panthers will get the football back. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And can they take advantage? Their defense got the 4th down stop, and now they're hoping to find the end zone. A field goal wouldn't be enough to erase this 4th quarter deficit. Just a yard on the 1st down carry, so it's 2nd and 9. 1 yard gain brings up 2nd and 9. 4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So it's Panther football as we welcome you back. They come up on a 2nd down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down to the wire. They go play action. Mayfield. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by Minkah Fitzpatrick. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offensive coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They'll stay on the ground with Swift. And they'll lose yardage here. They go backwards to the 13-yard line. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up 3rd down. Here's Swift. And he'll be tackled right on the 10, well short of the 1st down. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts, as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. The kick by Crosby is good. So after 4 touchdowns in the game for this offense, this time they're forced into taking the 3.
But you did mention 4 touchdowns, right? So 4 out of 5, not too bad. I think that's a pretty good record for them.
This will be fielded inside the 5. And he'll be out of bounds across the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. Because now, you're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence. Charles, we saw a lot of points go up in this one. Certainly defensively, stuff that they can look at on film, don't you think?
No doubt about it. And they've got to go back and check where the errors are, how they're going to fix them, and continue to get better at what they do. But they also need a little adjustment with their confidence. To give up that many points, even if you win a game, that can hurt you.
So for the Lions,